9th स्टैंडर्ड पॉलिटिकल साइंस चैप्टर 4 जुडिशियल सिस्टम एक्सरसाइजेस फर्स्ट मेन फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स विद सुटेबल वर्ड्स द सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑफ इंडिया केम इनटू एग्जिस्टेंस इन डैश आंसर इज जनवरी 28, 1950 The retirement age of the High Court judges dash. Answer is 62. Third one, the judges are appointed by dash. Answer is the president. Fourth one, the head of revenue tax board is dash. Answer is Revenue Secretary. Fifth one, the Lok Adalats came into existence in the year dash. Answer is 1985. Second main, answer the following questions with group discussion. First question, explain the functions of Supreme Court. First one, original powers. Resolving the disputes between the union and the states and between the states, safeguarding the fundamental rights of citizens, interpreting the provisions of the constitution and passing on writs. These are all original powers. Second one, appellate powers. Citizens may file cases in the Supreme Court against the judgments given in the lower courts. The Supreme Court may accept such appeals and issue judgments in these matters. It may also give special directions to the citizens to file such appeals. These are all the appellate powers. Third one, advisory powers. The Supreme Court may advise the President when he seeks its opinion on important public issues. The President may consult the Supreme Court for advice on matters related to agreements and contracts entered by the governments formed before the implementation of this constitution. These are all about advisory powers. These are the three important powers of Supreme Court. Let's move to second question. Write a note on functions of high courts. The original power to resolve civil and criminal cases, naval, marital, and contempt of court cases. Second one. To admit appeals against the judgments passed by the subordinate courts in civil and criminal cases. Third one, to direct transfer of cases from the lower courts to the High Court, to supervise the working of the subordinate courts, to admit writ petitions, to safeguard the fundamental rights and other legal rights of citizens, to appoint the staff and regulating them. These are all about the functions of high courts. Third one, name the subordinate courts under the civil courts. Court of Subordinate Judges, कोर्ट ऑफ अडिशनल सबॉर्डिनेट जड्जेस, कोर्ट ऑफ मुनसिप्स, कोर्ट ऑफ अडिशनल मुनसिप्स. These are the subordinate courts under the civil courts. Fourth one, write a note on criminal courts. Criminal courts came into existence on 1st April 1974. They are also known as district magistrate courts. They function under the High Court. The highest criminal court at the district level is the Sessions Court. The district judge performs the functions of a judge of this court too. The court takes up crimes like murder, robbery, dacoity, etc. It has the powers to issue death sentences and also life imprisonment sentences. However, such sentences will have to be ratified by the High Court. Similarly, an appeal may be made to the High Court against the judgments given by the criminal court. There are other criminal courts functioning under criminal court. These are all about criminal courts. Fifth one, write a note on revenue courts. There are revenue courts in every district. They take up cases related to land tax, land records, etc. Revenue courts comprise the following courts: Tahsildar Court, District Subdivisional Officers Court, District Revenue Court or District Magistrate Court, Commissioners Court, and Revenue Board. These are all about revenue courts. Sixth one, what are reasons behind the establishment of Lok Adalat Court? In India, the legal procedure is time-consuming and expensive. As an alternative, the government has set up other forms of legal institutions which function faster and are less expensive. These institutions came into existence in 1985. One of them is Lok Adalat. It takes up cases from parties who mutually agree to settle the cases amicably. Due to all these reasons, the Lok Adalat courts have been established.